Sing praise to God who reigns above.
The God of all creation.
The God of our salvation. The God of power, the God of love.
The God of our salvation.
With healing balm my soul is filled and every faithless murmur stilled.
To God all praise and glory.
Let all who name Christ's holy name let all who own his power proclaim aloud the wondrous story. For Christ is Lord and Christ alone, to God all praise and glory. Let's sing that praise and glory with Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing.
Thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet, sung by flaming tongues above.
Praise the mount I'm fixed upon it, mount of thy redeeming love. Here I raise my Ebenezer, hither by thy help I'm come, and I hope by thy good pleasure safely to sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger, interposed his precious blood. How your kindness yet pursues me, how your seal it for thy courts above.
Here's my heart, Lord, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above.
Amen. You may be seated. We're so thankful for the gift of the Holy Spirit of Jesus Christ within us, that this Spirit of God through faith in Jesus Christ, the Lord describes him as the seal. The Holy Spirit is the seal which guarantees that which is to come. This taste of eternity, that the presence of God, the presence of the Spirit of God within us, that points to what the glory of God is going to be like unhindered and forever. Well, good to be with you today at Ogama Hills Church. Good to gather together in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and give all our attention to him. That's what life is to be about and eternity is to be about, but sometimes we get busy with other things, don't we? And our eyes get turned here and there with responsibilities and things that we're into and giving our attention to, but it's wonderful to come together and turn our hearts entirely to him as his people. I'd like to invite you to fill out a Connect card during the service today, if you would. Just let us know you were here. Use this as an opportunity to connect with us. Give us feedback. As you turn the cards over, there's a place to fill out a prayer request, and you can drop those in the offering baskets as they go by a little bit later. If you miss that, you can take them to the welcome desk, which is on your right-hand side in the lobby on your way out, and use that as an opportunity again to connect with us, and we love to connect with each other in prayer as well. Lots of upcoming activities to get involved in, things to mark down on your calendar, and take note of things in the weekly schedule to plug in with. In the left-hand side of the inside of your bulletin, if you make note of that, each week there's listings of groups that meet, Bible studies going on, ways to get connected with God and with people in deeper ways. So please take advantage of those opportunities as the Lord would lead. And we just wanted to encourage you specifically, keep praying for our Honduras mission team as they are currently on the field doing the work of the Lord. The reports we've gotten back are great, that they've had opportunity to do a food distribution with Give to Give Hope for the kids that are sponsored, which is always an amazing privilege. Some of you that have gone on teams have had that privilege. They did water filters. They're going to work on one of the dear, lovely, older women's houses in the area, Ophelia. And so keep praying for them because God's working. Todd Frank sent me a few pictures yesterday of one of our sponsor kids, and he just said, everything's going great, and that was it. He was gone. I tried to email him back, nothing, so it must be going great. So just keep praying for the crew as they continue to minister in the name of Jesus Christ, and pray for smooth travel on their return as well. This time we have the privilege of inviting Matt Bettleton to come. Matt is going to share of the wonderful ministry of Whispering Hope Ranch and just keep us up to date with what's going on as they launch into another heavy ministry season over the summer. So Matt, would you come?
Ooh. Ooh. I was blind, now I'm seeing in color. I was dead, now I'm living forever. I had failed, but you were my redeemer. I've been blessed beyond all measure. I was lost, now I'm found by the Father. I've been changed from a ruin to treasure.
I've been given. It's an exciting time for us because we're seeing that God is taking us to another level, another step. I'm going to give you a few facts because I always assume everybody knows who I am and who the ranch is. So I'm just going to clarify a few things. My name is Matt Bettleton. I'm the president of Whispering Hope Ranch Ministries. We have a board, and a lot of our board members attend church here. Kenny McCluskey, Wally Leach, Paul Johnson, Michelle, and Dan Holcomb. They're our board members, and keep Wally in your prayer. He's a little hurting today. And we're a 501c3 nonprofit ministry, and we're supported by this church and by a lot of people in this church financially and other churches. That's how we make our way through ministering to kids. Our mission statement is that Whispering Hope Ranch is to be used with Christ by bringing the message of salvation to the lost and hurting people through the use of his creation, the horse. Our focus is on children, not only for their salvation, but also to train future leaders. We desire to teach holiness and Christ's unending power to transform us into his image. That's our mission statement at the ranch. And to do this, we need you. And we need volunteers to help, especially going to this next step. I'm going to share a couple stories really quick with you about how God uses the ministry of horses with kids. I happened to go back. I was looking back at material, and now it's not papers I go back to. It's a laptop. And, times have changed. And I looked at that 2009, I had a laptop. It's amazing. But I had a story. It's called Snapshot of the Ranch. And it talked about an 8-year-old girl that came to the ranch for camp. This 8-year-old girl had just lost both her parents a week before she came to camp. And to watch exactly what took place in her life, why she came and rode horses. Just so you can get a glimpse of what it is, a lot of tears are shed and shared with horses. They bury their heads in the horse's neck and hug. they get relief. God uses it. And this little girl with a wet, damp horse, bringing him in, unsaddling, she just did that. Her week of being with us was a week that God used to help heal. Hard to believe this girl is 17 now. That was in 09. But this is just many stories that I could tell, and that we reach out to our community. We had Denise Limo bring a group of kids out. We work with the school in bringing kids that are in the high-risk type area. They have anger management, just issues. And we had a lot of boys this last time. Just to give you an idea, this happens more than once, that we have them there. We break down the walls to these kids. They have a lot of anger buildup. And they come from backgrounds that it used to be if you came from a poor home, a poor background, it was because you came from a divorced family. You were looked at as somebody that might be a troubled kid or had some problems. Now it's the kids don't even know their parents, or if they are, they're in jail. They're raised by their foster parents or grandparents. Their situation is just unbelievable at a lot of times. And we get these kids coming out here. And we get the chance to show them God's love. And the Holy Spirit, we pray that it thrives at our ranch. So when they set foot on that ground, they know they're someplace different, that God is there. And we get a chance to minister to these school kids. This last group we had there, when they got ready to leave, two of the boys said, "I never want to leave here." That's God. That's God. That's what our goal is to show them Christ and Christ's love. And the opportunities to have a mission in your backyard to work with kids that are hurting. If you're not in the jail ministry, I'm not, but there's people that are, they can tell you stories about how they minister to these people and how they feel for their kids that they can't be with. And I shared this with some people that came up to ride about these kids, of kind of homes they come from. And they said, "Up here? Northern Michigan? No, you're talking about the city. No, there's drugs and there's alcoholism and there's abuse that happens right in our backyard, and a chance for us to minister to these families and to these kids." We're going to go to our next phase of this ministry. And God has provided us an opportunity to build an indoor arena so that we can minister to kids. Justin, show some pictures of our winter. We've worked with kids in Michigan winters. It's not the greatest place to have kids out on horses, especially up on our ranch. We have wind up there more than you get down here. It just happens. I guess I can look at this one. Okay, you can get an idea that walking and ministering to kids in snow is not an easy job, especially when you're a volunteer. But kids, when they come in from school, generally don't dress like they really should, a lot of them. And so before they even get a chance to get on the horse, half their therapy is touching and being with the horse. Okay, so that's half their time. Then they got to come in and warm up, and then they got to get on the horse, which they want to do, but their teeth are chattering, they're cold. And by the time we get them on there, they can only spend maybe 15, 20 minutes, and they're back off again. God has made available to us a new opportunity. And Justin, why don't you go ahead and show us this?
I'm happy, it's easy to see. I'm high on the mountain, the world at my feet. All of the reasons I should feel free. Come and look closer, it's not about me. It's all about Him and the love that He gives. Redemption and hope for all who have sinned. You can walk all alone, never find your way home. Till you see deep within, it's all about Him. It's not about ego or things you can hold. It's not about power or silver or gold. Not who's at your table. Where you lay down, it's not about spreading your wings on the ground. It's all about Him and the love that He gives. Redemption and hope for all who have sinned. You can walk all alone, never find your way home. Till you see deep within, it's all about Him.
Isn't that beautiful to see what God is doing and how we come? That we've been working on this project for a long time. And we're to the point now where we're looking at full-time staff. Because once this is finished, we're going to be able to utilize this ministry year-round. We'll be inside. We'll be in where it's warm. You've seen the lean-to area, Mark Masonville, and we had volunteers, Ray Adams, and people that come along, and we've got in-floor heat that's ready. We got a outdoor wood burner that was donated for heat. And we got people looking at considering maybe helping us out with a boiler system. Things are coming together, but we need your help in a lot of ways to make this happen. So we have a sign-up sheet out back. And we got Paul Johnson is heading our work team. And he needs help. He needs some hands. And so we need you to, I looked at the sign-up sheet out there, and somebody's been writing with invisible ink. Because I don't see one name out there. If you can help, you don't have to be a master carpenter, okay? All you have to do is be able to read a tape ruler, be able to sort wood, be able to just be an extra hand. The end of next week, on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, if you can help out in any of those days, sign up. We'll feed you. We'll feed you good. And come and help us and be part of this. Now, I'm right at the end of my time, so I'm just going to say, if you don't have a ministry, a mission, you don't have to love horses. You know, when you go to Honduras, it's not air-conditioned climate where you work, right? I mean, there it's very uncomfortable. If you have to smell some horse turds, I'm sure you will survive. We really need people to love God and love kids. It's all. Just to be able to talk to the kids, be able to help them, tell them it's going to be all right, Tell them that this horse is, you know, you can do it and be around and help out. So if and this is our year-round ministry. If you feel like you don't have anything going on, that you want to really plug into a ministry and you want to help and be there with kids, not just building, but be in there ministering to kids. And it's not like you're every day. It's once a week maybe, once every other week that you can plug in. So keep us in your prayers. This building, we want to have a hoedown in October. We want to see this finished by then. So keep that in prayer, and we need your helping hands. Sign up out there. I have literature. Michelle has literature back there. And before I close, everybody that's been and helped at the ranch and has volunteered, could you please stand up, please? Do we have some people here? Board members, anybody that's been part of it? Raise back there. Okay, here we go. Okay, so there's lots of room for more, okay? That you can see that. So keep us in our prayers, your prayers. Pray about what God would have you do as a ministry, a mission in your backyard. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Matt. And it really is top-notch, life-changing ministry in our own backyard. And don't you think sometimes we take things like that for granted, don't we? You know, a ministry of that caliber is right there in Rose City. Connected with us directly here at the church. And so pray about how you can get involved. Just be some extra hands and be some extra hearts, you know, just to love up the kids and support the minister in real practical ways. Will you please stand with me? We'll turn our eyes to the Lord in prayer and prepare our hearts to worship him in song. Lord, we thank you so much for who you are. You are an amazing God. There's no one like you, Lord. And so this whole invitation you've made by your grace to come and get involved in what you're doing in the lives of people in the world today, God, it's humbling to say the least. And God, we know that's your invitation even now. Come and meet with you in your presence. And so, God, we want to come to you on your terms, not because of our righteousness or some sort of goodness within us that deserves your presence. Lord, we know that's the furthest thing from the truth, but it's by your grace. You call us because of the gift of your one and only Son, Jesus Christ. You call us to come near. So, Lord, on those terms, through our faith in Christ, we come near to you. Lord, we want to express to you in song who you are to us, what you mean to us. So we worship you. So come and meet us right where we are. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Lifted high. the storm was rolled away. His perfect love could not be overcome. Now death, where is your sting? Our resurrected King has rendered you defeated. Forever He is glorified. Forever He is lifted high. Forever He is risen. He is alive. He is
you have given. the inside, Jesus. You have given us freedom. No longer bound by sin and darkness, living in the light of your goodness. You have given us freedom. Now I have resurrection power, living on the inside, Jesus. You have given us freedom. No longer bound by sin and darkness, living in the light of your goodness. You have given us freedom. You have given us freedom. You have given us freedom. You have given us freedom.
Thanks be to you, Lord Jesus. Free us from all that binds us, Lord. Come out of sadness.
Come out of sadness from wherever you've been. Come brokenhearted, let rescue begin. Come find your mercy, O sinner, come kneel. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal. Lay down your burdens.
Lay down your burdens.
We hear your invitation to come in our brokenness, to come in our questions, to come in our weakness, to come to you. So, Lord, we do just that by faith. We come to you this morning to lay our burdens at your feet, to let you wash over us, to cleanse us, to bring forgiveness to our lives, to fill us up with your Spirit. Give us joy and love and peace. We come to you, Lord, to receive from you what only you can give, yourself. So have your way in our lives, Lord, and we give ourselves to you freely and entirely. God, is an expression of our worship this morning, we want to give in a tangible way as we take up a morning tithes and offerings. And Lord, we don't in any way give to get from you. We give because you're worthy of our everything. So, Lord, we give out of an overflow of worship and gratitude. And God, we ask you to take this offering that we give by faith and receive it, Lord. Multiply it and touch the nations with it. We thank you, Lord, for your goodness. We thank you for your love for people. And thank you for your invitation to be involved in what you're doing here in our community, in our area, and around the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. Ushers, those assisting with the offering, would you come at this time? Thank you so much, Carol and Jamie. Aren't you thankful that God is strong enough to hold you fast? Anybody get kind of wiggly sometimes? Some of you that have kids and grandkids, do you remember that age where when they were kind of upset and they wanted out of your arms, they could make themselves go from about 15 pounds to 55 pounds by the way they kind of did their bodies? It's miraculous. And sometimes we get that way with God, don't we? You know, we get a little fussy on the inside and we get kind of wiggly. And God's grace is amazing, isn't it? To hold on to us, to cling to us, till we come to our senses by his grace and reestablish our grip on him. Our God is amazing.